everyone. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to webinar series at EDSA University 2022 with the theme, An Avenue to English Mastery. The Honorable our lecturer, Mrs. Arin Nurlida, PMPD, and the Honorable all my beloved presenters and participants. First of all, let us thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of his blessing you are able to come here training this webinar. Salawat and salam always be given to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who has guided us from the darkness into the brightness. I'm Zafira Marini, student of 6th semester of English Education Department 2019, Siloam University, and I'll be your moderator for today's session. All right, for the presenter today are the students of English Education Department, Siloam University. They are Zahra Duangreni, Raihana Permatasari, Tasya Meita, Putri Permatasari, Shaila Nailulwa, Nisa Tintin Rusmiati, Agnia Siva Mulyani, Nidan Fitya Ramadhani, and the last, Tilinga Putra Kurnia. Before we start the presentation session, I would like to deliver the regulations for EDSA's webinar series 2022. This webinar will last for 1.5 hours. The only language used to communicate is English. All participants are suggested to take notes during the presentation. All participants must turn off the audio during the presentation. The presentation will be held in 5 until 7 minutes for each presenter. The moderator will set the time to remind the presenter. The Q&A session will come after the whole presentation. Questions can be typed in the chat box since the early presentation. Furthermore, anyone interested in talking directly to the presenters is pleased to raise your hand. We will facilitate you if we still have time. If you couldn't get the answer, the presenters will send the answer via email. All right, without any further ado, we are going to the presentation session. For the first presenter, I would like to invite Zahra Duangreni with her topic, Let's Speak Like Leaders, Tip Jobs for Your Better Action. Zahra, please. Is there Zahra here?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, I'm sorry.
Please.
All right. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, everyone. Firstly, I would like to say thank you to the moderator for hosting this webinar. Secondly, Excellency, all the lecturers for attending this meeting or webinar session. Let me introduce myself. My name is Zahra Duangreni. As the speaker for my topic today, my topic is Let's Speak Like a Leader, Steve Jobs for Your Better Action. I will divide my presentation into defining leader, show how Steve Jobs' speaking style, and conclusion. So without any further ado, let's start. Next. Ladies and gentlemen, speaking skill must be owned by a leader. It's free. For me, it's yes. The more people you can connect with, the more change you can implement. Don't follow the crowd, let the crowd follow you. People are more likely to be influenced by the person speaking in front of them. So imagine that you can bring and you can drive with powerful public speaking skill. Public speaking skill is when all these people gather together in a single audience, public speaking skill is related to how we work. From here, we know that leader deals in activities of talking or speaking. Talking about leader, what is a leader? Next, please. Leader is someone who leverage their relational influence with a team of people to get the right things accomplished through these people. My colleague. All right, everyone. Who is your favorite leader? I want you to think about a masterful leader, a great leader, a legendary leader. You can write in the chat box. Here I have Nelson Mandela, John F. Kennedy, Barack Obama, Martin Luther King, or yourself. It's okay if you choose yourself as the best leader in your life. Now, if you look at the great leaders of humanity like here, but I will show you who is the best leader in business builder. Steve Jobs. Next, please. Steve Jobs was a master of salesman. He knew exactly what to say to make people believe in impossible. So point number one, to be a world-class leader and a masterful communicator in terms of your influence is precision of your language. Spend a lot of your time on your influence. You probably do as well. Remember what's emergency? Next, please. Nobody is born to be a good communicator, but you're gonna work at it and you can. So everyone, today I will show you how Steve Jobs' public speaking style. Let's watch this video.
This is a day I've been looking forward to for 2.5 years. Every once in a while, a revolutionary product comes along that changes everything. And Apple has been, well, first of all, one's very fortunate if you get to work on just one of these in your career. Apple's been very fortunate. It's been able to introduce a few of these into the world. 1984.
Stop, please.
Macintosh.
Thank you. Now, Steve Jobs' super skill with presenting in public speaking is his key factor in his success. There were many bright and talented people in the field of computer since 1970s and 80s, but few had confidence and verbal ability of Steve Jobs. First, next please. The style of Steve Jobs, conversational speaking. The biggest things that stand out is his easy, calm, and conversational style. Some of the most effective speakers have this quality, where it feels like one-on-one conversation between them and you. Over time, simple presentation. In a small room like this, involve intimacy, precise events, complete with a stage, professional lighting, and a big screen, like Steve Jobs before. But Steve Jobs always maintained his accessible conversational persona, and this was irresistible to crowds. In a way, this is difficult quality to learn if you are born with it. It takes a certain amount of comfort and ease in front of a large group. Second, clear and calm voice. The second thing that stands out is that he speaks in clear but calm voice. Many speakers make the mistake of raising their voice unnecessarily or unnaturally. This saps their energy during the course of the presentation and exhausts them. Steve Jobs always had a normal, even tone throughout, and this helped him last for very long presentation with a consistent energy of level. The third is mastery of the subject. And the third of operation is his master of subject. He feels humor, personal opinions, recent accomplishment, and future goals into a broad narrative. This comprehensive way of presenting is almost impossible to deliver when it's scripted, unless you are really good actor. It can only be done when you have full mastery of the subject in question. By this point, Steve Jobs had been living in a breathing computer's art and software for many details of stories and opportunities on the horizon would elude more casual participants in the field. Ladies and gentlemen, that is how Steve Jobs speaking. For the conclusion, next please. I conclude that speaking is a way to be a good leader, where we can communicate well. We as the younger generation must improve and improve our speaking skill because it is a very, very useful for our future. For example, being a good leader like Steve Jobs. Next. So if this doesn't motivate you, nothing new. Steve Jobs here, Zahra Dwi Anggraeni. Thank you so much for your great attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, Zahra, for your nice explanation. Okay, everyone, we're next to the next presenter. I would like to invite Raihana Permatasari with her topic, Active Listening Skills and Pep Songs. Come check this. Raihana, please.
All right. Thank you to the moderator, Kazafira Marahaini, for giving me time to talk in this webinar. And I would like to express my gratitude to the lecturer on this subject, Academic Listening and Speaking course, Mrs. Arini Nurul Hidayati, who has guided me so that I can speak in this EDSA webinar on Academic Presentation 2022. All right, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. How are you today? I hope all my dear audience is here in a good condition. In this beautiful day, I'd like to bring a topic that related to one aspect of English skills, that is listening skills. The specific theme is active listening skills with a favorite song. Come check this. Next, please. I will divide my presentation today in four sections. The first one is what active listening skill is. Second, active listening ex English songs. Third, what an informant say. And the last is conclusion. Next, please. Let's begin with what active listening skill is. According to Jambron, active listening requires listening for the content, intent, and feeling of the speaker. The active listener shows her or his interest verbal and nonverbal with question and visual cues signifying that the other person has something important to say. Also, Grunkheimer says that listening includes hearing, interpreting, absorbing, storing, and retrieving information. But beside that, he says that listening is a complex process, which involves sensing, interpretation, evaluation, and response. So basically, active listening means that you have a listening sensitivity where you will absorb information, stay engaged, pay attention, because this is the most important part of active listening. And last but not least, respond to the person you are talking to. This shows that we are interested in what they have to say. Next, please. So, how can English songs improve us as active listeners? First, we can knowing the meaning. Today's era, a lot of music genre we heard, but we only enjoy that melody and rhythm and not knowing the meaning of the songs. So by this kind of activity, active listening skills, we can know the meaning of the songs that we listen. Second, improving another skills. Besides listening skills, using the song as media can help you in improving writing skills. Why? For example, if you want to learn grammar by using English songs, you can find If I Were a Boy songs by Beyoncé. In the lyrics, she presented with the correct grammar, so you can learn from that song. And the last is you will get more new vocabulary in English. Basically, if you hear the new English songs that are just randomly play or hear new songs in social media, in radio, or in coffee shop, automatically your curiosity will find the meaning of vocabulary just heard. Like for example, you listen to Beyoncé's songs and found the word destroy. Then your brain was thinking that what that means of destroy, like you will probably open your dictionary or maybe translate that words on Google Translate. Well, it's according to my experience because I like to do this activity for improving my active listening skills. So what an informant say for this activity? Here I present briefly the research article conducted by Liz Jianingzi. The informant says that studying listening activities using English songs was very fun, flexible, and enjoyable learning method. They learn to improve their active listening skills with English songs is want to know the content of the songs. Aside from that, they also want to try to find the meaning of vocabulary words in the English songs. Also, the abilities that can be obtained when listening to English songs are pronunciation, grammar, speaking, and vocab. So it will help them in improving listening skills. Of course, they feel happy when doing this activity because they enjoying the rhythm and melody of the songs. So according to what was conveyed by Purcell, students can become bored repeatedly listening to a narration or dialogue as they attempt to understand the meaning of new words or phrases in context. So in contrast, listening to song over and over again can seem less monotonous because of the rhythm and melody. We can do this activity while do some exercise, in car, maybe when cooking, etc. It's so flexible, and I think we always listen to English songs in every way, every day. For example, if we open the social media, there was a song, especially on Instagram, maybe, or TikTok application, I guess. Next, please. So here I have a challenge for you to listen around 20 seconds of Wallerman's song from Nathan Evans. I think this song is simple, quite clear, and not too fast. So first you will listen to these songs and after that guess the lyric first, and then that I will show you the original lyrics of the song. So here we go.
There once was a ship that put to sea. The name of the ship was a Bully of Tea. The winds blew up her bow, up down, oh below my bully boys blow. Soon may the Willowman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go.
Alright, you can show the original lyric, moderator. Alright, so are your active listening skill is work based on this lyric? If your suggestion or guessing lyric of this song is correct, then your active listening skill is work. But if not, don't be sad, don't worry. From now, you can improve your active listening ability with your favorite songs or maybe new English songs that you find. So this activity that I give implies that you have practiced how to improve active listening skill with English songs. Can you get it? All right, so next, please. It can be concluded that listening skill is an important ability to have in learning English because this will be one of the keys to have successful communication between those who speak and those who listen. Practicing in listening activities using English songs as media can be considered as an exciting thing. In addition, English songs are easy to find on any platform such as YouTube, Jokes, or Spotify. So this can be used as recommendation too for teachers who will teach listening in their classroom. Besides teachers, for English foreign language students also recommended to try this learning method. Because it's flexible, you don't have to take a class or courses, and this activity can be done without any special schedule. So I put a quote obtained from Pinterest because I think this quote has a good meaning or message. Learn to be a good listener, your ears will never get you into trouble. So I think having the ability to actively listen will make you have good communication so that you will also have a good relationship. And the last slide is the references that I use for my presentation today. All right, thank you for your attention. I'll give it back to moderator.
Thank you, Raihana, for your great explanation. All right, everyone, I would like to invite the next presenter, Tasya Mehta, with her topic, Role Play for College Students Speaking Enhancement. How does it work? Tasya, please.
All right, hello. Am I audible?
Yes.
Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you very much, moderator, for hosting the meeting and give me the opportunity to speak here. And the Honorable, the lecture of Academic Listening and Speaking, which is Arini Nurul Hidayati, the Honorable, the lecture of Siloam University, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, good morning. My name is Tasya Mehta. So on this nice occasion, I'd like to deliver a presentation that have related with speaking by the title, A Role Play for College Student Speaking Enhancement. How does it work? So I'll divide my presentation into three sections, like first the opening, introduction of the opening, body to explain, and then the conclusions. So I'll start by reciting basmalah first, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. And let's see the topic outlined here. Thank you very much, moderator. Our today's discussion here about the definition and types, the organization of role play, the example, how does it work, and then the conclusion. Before I explain to you, have you ever heard about role play? Anyone? You can type in the chat box. Or have you ever played a role? Wonderful. Wonderful. Thank you very much. Yes. So as a college student, after we graduation, we might apply job. You might want to be a new center. You might want to be a YouTuber, or you might want to be a customer service because you great at the communication. That's why we learn about role play. But what is role play, everyone? So let's take a look together for the definition and types of role play. In the next slide, of course. All right, what is role play? The year is 1987, defines that the word role is there are play a part, either their own or somebody else in a specific situation, and the word play means that the role is taken on in a safe environment in which students are as inventive and playful as possible. So we can conclude that role play is an activity that are carried out by students to play as somebody else's profession or somebody else's characteristic. And you know what? That there are two different types of role play. Can you show us, moderator? All right, so there are real play and surreal play. So a role play activity which is carried out to rehearsal yourself for the real world is called real play. In sharp with real play, surreal play should create an imagination thing or build imagination mind in students. So real play here, I have an example for you, like customer service, news center, and so on, because this is the job that does exist in the real world. And in surreal play, it's like you play theater or drama. You might be a princess, or the man be a prince, or maybe I become Snow White with dwarves. So it's like imagination things. All right, and the next slide, we are going to talk about the organization of role play. So I want your nice attention on this point, because if you want to conduct in a successful role play, here are your organizations. So first, the educator has to be convicted that role play is an exciting technique to use and has many benefits. So except for that, we as an educator, we have to trigger our students. We have to tell them that by connecting this technique, it will benefit you. It will train your speaking skills, especially in different social contexts. Equally importantly, realia can help to bring role play in real life, in life. So for instance, when we ask our students to play customer and then waiters, we might ask them to bring napkins or write menus to the classroom. Next, Doug explicates the demonstration of roleplay is significant. So the teacher task is not only to tell them what to do, but you might also elicit like some structures that need to be need by the student. And finally, Huang proposes that the teacher should assess the effectiveness of roleplay and examine them. So it's not task is not only to tell them what to do, but we have to like examine whether our students successfully conducting their role, play their role. And you might like wondering how is roleplay look like. So in the next slide, I have example for you, like a roleplay in the college student. So okay, so here's the example. Can you play? And let's watch it together.
Hello everyone, my name is Rayana Parmatasari. My student's number is 20212145. I'm from class D, professional listening and speaking. In this video, I want to show you how to make Korean barbecue at home. If you want to know the recipe, just keep on watching.
Can you see it? It's really fun activity. Can you guess what role that she plays? Main apa sih gitu? What is the role that she plays here? YouTuber! That's right! Thank you very much everyone! That's true. She's playing a role as YouTuber, but actually there are many roles that students can play. Actually, I didn't touch like a whole video, but if you want to watch it, you could visit our channel as usual, or you can explore more on Minerva, Aphrodite, and also Artemis. So, next slide, let's see what we have here, moderator. Right, so this is library research that's conducting by students at college at Riau University. This is like the proof how does roleplay affect students' speaking ability. At the first and the second point, you can see by Anna and Bella, you can see there it's word of stimulate. So this would have the same meaning that roleplay is an activity that can stimulate the students to practice or prepare themselves for the real world. In the third and the fourth points by Angie and Viva, it said that roleplay can boost students' interaction in the classroom and a lot of listening and attention grabbing. Yes, that's correct. Because why? Because when we play a role, it's not you play alone, but sometimes we play in a group. For example, in my previous course, we play in a group like United Nations and then a teacher forum. So we dress up, we adjust our appearance, like how to look, how we look like as a teacher. We dress batik, or we talk from different accents, like how to talk from like British accent, American accent, or maybe India accent, and so on. So it's like a lot of listening and attention grabbing. And finally, in the next slide, I have reached my final session here to present my presentation. So as my closing here, I have a quote for you. Okay, can you move to the next slide? So here, for every different roles you play, it's nice to have a challenge for each one by Freddie Highmore. And as my final closing, I want to it's the conclusion. So yes, roleplay is one of the best techniques to make students speak. Yes, it can train your interpersonal skills. As Polska believe that it's a wide range of roleplay can train students speak in any social context. So everyone, thank you very much for your nice attention. Once again, for every different role you play, it's nice to have different challenge for each one. And remember that actually ourselves, we play our role. I play a role as Tasha, Kazabira play a role as moderator, and everyone, you play a role as yourself, as a be yourself. And finally, it's my final closing. I want to give you a fine tune. So listening to Shawn Mendes' Imagination, Imagination, and playing Society Is You. Thank you for nice attention, and nice to meet you, and Tasha Mita. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, and please back to Kazabira.
Thank you, Tasha, for your great explanation. Okay, everyone, I would like to invite the next presenter. Putri Permatasari with her topic, the effects of using Kahoot on English vocabulary learning. Putri, please.
Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thanks, moderator, for giving me opportunity. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm standing in front of you and allow me to deliver my presentation. But before that, let me introduce myself. My name is Putri Permatasari from PASTI. My topic today is about the effect of using Kahoot on English vocabulary learning. This talk has three major sections, namely introduction, body, and conclusions. Okay, next slide, please. Here, there is a table of content consisting of five. The first is vocabulary mastery easy? The second is Kahoot game provide high level of motivation. The third is using the Kahoot game make it easy for students to remember vocabulary. The fourth is using Kahoot game can increase vocabulary. And the last is conclusions. Okay, next slide. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here I want to ask you first, is vocabulary mastery easy? You can write in the chat box. Okay, okay, maybe some of you choose difficult and the other choose easy. All right. One of the difficult parts of learning the target language for English learner is vocabulary mastery. Vocabulary learning is an integral part of language learners. However, it is difficult. Although there are so many proposed techniques for vocabulary learning and teaching, researchers are still trying to find an effective method. Recently, using educational games to teach vocabulary has been very popular for the kids. According to Donmus 2010, page 1499, when games and education are combined, they can be educative and can educational environment can be entertaining. Learners who learn by using games get a positive attitude and can be more motivated by learning. A repetition vocabulary games and word wall are effective learning strategy to improve student vocabulary mastery. The online game Kahoot fulfills all these practices. It serves as a formative assessment review, interactive in the sense that it can be played over and over again, and serves as a virtual word wall because vocabulary terms can be clearly displayed on the smart board. Okay, next slide. All right. The effect of Kahoot game in vocabulary learning are the first. Kahoot game provide high level of motivation. According to author Lubiana 2019, I cited in Rismawati 2020, Kahoot application is one way to provide learning experience that can increase student motivation in learning. The implication of Kahoot can increase student learning motivation because it is designed in interesting and fun way. Kahoot is an alternative choice from a variety of interactive learning media that makes the learning process fun and not boring for both students and teachers. Because the Kahoot media emphasizes a learning style that involves the active role, a relationship of student participants with their peers competitively, Kahoot takes advantage of aspect fun, curiosity, and inclusiveness that exist in humans. Play is the first language that humans learn. When the learning process is turned into fun, the learning it will be interesting for everyone. Curiosity is part of nature human. This is what drives the creation of a great effort. With curiosity, humans will always be encouraged to continue study. While inclusive means open to everyone, because Kahoot can play by various groups ranging from student to employees. All right, next slide, please. The second is using the Kahoot game makes it easy for students to remember vocabulary. According to Ismania 2018, one way to make it easier for children to remember vocabulary is by playing online games, namely for online games Kahoot. Also aim to make the easier, especially for members, terms of mastery of memory vocabulary. Learning this must be designed to be fun, it will be easier to remember vocabulary. Kahoot gets up the fun learning games to answer the difficulties of remembering less vocabulary. Kahoot is not only fun, but also increase children's ability to master technology information and communication. Learning using Kahoot has a good features, interesting with pictures, video, and creative answer options. Besides that, the Kahoot features is very simple, so that it is easy to understand and easy to access anywhere. Okay, next slide. All right, this is the last but not least, using Kahoot game increase vocabulary. According to Abrams and Walsh, 2014, found that using technology-based games for vocabulary teaching increased student vocabulary assessment score from low B mean before the game was played to low A mean. Like my experience, when I continue to practice my vocab using the game Kahoot, it helped me to improve my vocabulary. Previously, I got a small score after trying this Kahoot game, my score went up. Because when using this application, we can repeat what we don't understand until we really, really understand. Okay, next slide. Okay, guys, now heading to the end, and which is conclusions. From all that I have said, there are three very important points. The first is Kahoot game is very helpful in learning vocabulary so that students easy memorize with enjoyment. The second is the use of the Kahoot game should be continued because it will be useful for students and teachers. And the last is vocabulary learning is very important because without vocabulary, nothing can convey. All right, guys, I hope this material can be useful for all of us. And thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I give it back to moderator.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, Putri, for your great explanation. All right, everyone, I would like to invite the next presenter, Sheila Naili Ulwa, with her topic, Fun Vocabulary Learning with Flashcards. Sheila, please.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thanks to the moderator for giving me the opportunity, and thank you to the all of the audience who attending this webinar today. I would like to introduce myself. My name is Sheila Nailiwa. In this occasion, I would like to bring the topic about fun vocabulary learning with flashcards. Next slide. Here I have divided my presentation into four main parts. Number one is definition of flashcard. Number two, flashcard for elementary students. Number three, advantages of flashcard. And the last, research result and conclusion. Before we move, I would like to ask, does anyone know about flashcard? All right, thank you for the answer. Let's discuss more about flashcard. Definition of flashcard. According to Scrivener, flashcards for English language teaching is jargon for pictures or diagrams, words, and so on that you can show to students. Typically, something that you can hold up when standing in front of the whole class. So in other words, characteristic of flashcards media is a picture that accompanied with the word as a caption. There are several categories of pictures that can be used on the flashcard, such as animals, fruits, colors, shapes, numbers, feelings, profession, and so on. Next slide. Next, in using a flashcard, flashcard should be visible, big, and clear enough to be seen by all students, so they can see the detail of the flashcard. and the image of the flashcard should convey the message clearly. And the last, flashcard should be appropriated with the material that will be taught to students. Next. So for example, you can start to ask your students, how are they feeling today? Are they happy or sad? Next slide, please. And can the use of flashcard improve students' vocabulary at elementary school? Yes, according to Soliha, in elementary school, vocabulary is one of English components that must be taught to the learners. They study about simple words or things in their surroundings. So it is aimed that students are able to understand simple English used in daily contexts. Moreover, flashcards is an interesting media that can attract students' interest. And moreover, it makes students easy to memorize the material. Next slide. Here are some advantages of flashcards. Number one is flashcard can be used for consolidating vocabulary. It makes students motivated in learning. And moreover, flashcard is eye-catching. And number two, flashcard is effective that can be used for any level of students. Number three, flashcard can be taken and studied almost everywhere and anytime. Number four, flashcards are cost-effective or inexpensive. Number five, flashcard provide visual link between L1, or our native language, and the target language. And the last, flashcard can be used for practicing structure or for a variety of games. Next slide. Based on the research for Selina and Dewi 2017, showed that flashcards can develop students' vocabulary. The study was conducted in Lab School, Setiabudi, South Jakarta, in third grade, consists of 40 students, showed that students' understanding of English vocabulary by using flashcard media can help students to develop cognitive abilities in describing the image and can develop their vocabulary because basically flashcard very easy to understand. Next slide. Here is the conclusion. It can be concluded that flashcard is one of the most useful media applications in learning vocabulary that can be applied in the classroom, especially for elementary students, which would make teaching and learning more interesting and fun. With flashcard, students' vocabulary can be improved because they can memorize the words easily. And moreover, flashcard makes students familiar with the word and encourage them to learn and know more about vocabulary. Next slide. Here are some references that I use in this PowerPoint. That's all from my presentation. I'm sorry if there are any mistakes. Thank you so much for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I will give it back to moderator.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, Saila, for your great explanation. All right, everyone, I would like to invite for the next presenter, Nisa Tintin Rusmiati, with her topic, the importance of reading strategies to improve student literacy in Indonesia. Nisa, please.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, moderator, for hosting the meeting, and thank you for giving me the opportunity. Excellency Ms. Arini Nurul Hidayati, and Excellency ladies and gentlemen who were present today. I'm Nisa Tintin Rusmiati. On this occasion, I'd like to bring a topic about the importance of reading strategies to improve student literacy in Indonesia. Next, please. Which on the first slide, there is a table of content, which is the first one, a condition of reading literacy in Indonesia. The second is the reason that make students less literate reading, and the third is the reading strategy to improve literacy, and the last is conclusion. Next, please. And so, before getting into the topic, I want to ask, do you know how the condition of reading literacy in Indonesia is? Okay, the condition of reading recognition of reading literacy according to Abdul Muhaimin Iskandar, say that literacy in Indonesia based on UNESCO data was second from the bottom. In Indonesia, interest currently very low. Moreover, the COVID-19 pandemic continued to undermine interest in reading. UNESCO data state that the reading interest of the Indonesian people is very concerning, only 0.001%. This means that out of 1,000 Indonesians, only 1% is an avid reader. In addition, the Program for International Student Assessment survey in 2015 also placed Indonesia at 64 out of 72 countries. During the period 2012 until 2015, the PISA score for reading only increased by 1 point from 396 to 397. The test results show that the ability to understand and use reading materials, especially text document, Indonesian children age 9 until 14 years is in the bottom 10. Next, please. And then what makes students less literate in reading? According to Haryadi, it is likely that low reading interest rate is because Indonesian children are lazy to read books, as what is claimed by most people, but it is not always the case. Meanwhile, according to Tahmidatan et al., there are several causes of the low reading ability and culture of students in Indonesia. The first, the development of reading skill is still perceived as part of the responsibility of language subject only. And the second, reading a material learning activity and practice or evaluation question that exists in teaching material in school tend to still well on low other thinking skills. And the third, the infrastructure and supplies of the school library have not been maximized as a center for developing student reading skills. And the next slide. What is reading strategy to improve literacy? There are many reading strategies to improve student literacy, but there are some of them. The first strategy is for predicting reading content. The strategy of predicting the content of the reading helps the reader to connect the knowledge they have to understand the topic, so that the reader combines the process of what is already known with the new material in the reading. Predicting the content of the reading is done best on the key reading, such as a picture, illustration, subtitles, and plots. And the second is skimming and scanning strategies. Skimming is a reading technique to find the main idea or main points of the reading as a whole. So when using the technique, you will be able to get an overview of the content of the reading, even if you don't read all of the writing. While scanning is used when you already know what we want to find, so that it will focus on the content of a specific book. And the third is strategy image with caption. Reading the picture is describing the picture thought and explanation of what is contained in the picture. Referring to Armstrong's opinion, the image reading strategy is a learning application on the visual spatial intelligence part. And Gatry et al. Said that there are 6 strategies from teachers to support students' reading activities in the classroom and other to improve literacy. Namely, number 1, construct rich knowledge goal to student experiences of reading instruction. And the second, use real-world interaction to connect reading to student experiences. And number 3, afford student an abundance of interesting books and materials. And number 4, provide so choice among material to read. Number 5, give redirect instruction for important reading strategies. And then the last, encourage collaboration in many aspects of learning. Using the practice create a context for engagement in literacy learning. Next, please. And the last is conclusion. So we can know that the state of reading literacy in Indonesia is still low. This is from the lack of student willingness to read more. In addition, something that reading is still felt as part of the responsibility of language subject only, then few from reading materials and facilities and infrastructure. The strategy to improve reading literacy is initiated by students themselves and can be supported by teacher. Therefore, with all the things students can improve their reading with various strategies that he chose, and the support from the teacher and can be used as motivation. That's all from me. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I give it back to moderator.
Thank you for your nice explanation, Nisa. Next, we move to the next presenter. I would like to invite Aynia Sipamulyani with her topic, Webtoon, a solution for college students' vocabulary. Aynia, please.
Thank you so much, moderator, for giving me the opportunity. Okay, and also thank you for the participants that attend this webinar today. Hello, my name is Agnes Shifamulyani, and in this occasion, I would like to bring a topic about vocabulary learning, and my title of my presentation is about Webtoon, a solution for college students' vocabulary. Next, please. And I'll divide my presentations into four sections, and this is what we'll discuss today. But before we go to the topic, I would like to ask everybody here, did you know about Webtoon? Next slide, please. Next slide. All right. Thank you for the responses. Actually, I would like to explain more about Webtoon. So according to Wulandar et al. In 2019, Webtoon is a combination of web and cartoon or a comic. And comic can be defined as the form of a cartoon to express the characters and apply the story that have related with the pictures. So here's the questions. Does it help in learning vocabulary? Can you click, moderator? All right, and to answer these questions, I conducted a survey to 6 semester of English education students at Siliwangi University. And from that survey, I found several findings and I also can answer these questions. Next, please. So the answer for these questions is that gonna be yes, that Webtoon can help college students to learn vocabulary. Why? It is the first reason is that because language in Webtoon can motivate college students to learn vocabulary. It is based on the survey that I conducted, about 68.45% participants agree with that. And it also in line with Jung's in 2010. Please click moderator. Yeah, because as you can see in the example right here, the language used in the Webtoon is varied and also entertaining. They provided the jokes and also the slang words. Next, please. All right, and the other reason is that because visualizations in Webtoon helped college students understand unfamiliar words. Based on the survey, about 75.5% participants agree with that, and it also in line with Sima Mor et al. In 2020. Although they find unfamiliar word, but they can guess the meaning of the word from the pictures. They can guess it from the expressions, from the moods that creates by the characters. As we can see the example right here, although I don't have an idea what this sentence means, but I can guess this 2 person is celebrating something and they are happy. And I think this man is a success doing something. So I think it's going to be better to read a webtoon rather than just read a text reading, because you can see the pictures, you can guess the pictures from the pictures, and also it's entertaining to read, so you'll never get bored when you read webtoon. Next, please. All right, and the another reason is that because Webtoon can expand college students' vocabulary, it is based on the survey, about 70.4% participants agree with that. It is because genres in Webtoon, it's so many. They are provided drama, fantasy, historical, and romance, and from each genre, they must be have a different language according to the story and the plot they made. For example, like the drama, like the language used in the drama would be different with the language used in a historical, although they have examining. So I think it's gonna expand your vocabulary knowledge. Next, please. Click, moderator. All right. It is also in line with Novian et al. In 2021. She stated that the more variety of genres in Webtoon, the more insight the reader will get. And the last reason, it is because Webtoon is an easy to use learning medium. It is passed also from the survey, about 52.4% participants didn't have difficulty in learning new vocabulary using Webtoon. So it is proven that Webtoon can help college students to learn vocabulary. And but did you know how to optimize it, how to optimize a Webtoon when you're learning vocabulary? Here I have a strategy to optimize it. Next, please. Thank you for the responses. So the strategies to optimize Webtoon for learning vocabulary. Here's a suggestion from Rob Rennick and Martin Sketchley. The first is to find the meaning of the word that you don't know right away. So when you read a Webtoon, then you find unfamiliar word, then you have to look it up then and there. It will help you to more remember the meaning of the word, because you can connect this the meaning of the word with the story that you read. And then the second is, while you're learning new words, keep a running list. Yes, it is very important that you have to keep record or not, whether it is in notebook, in applications and others, and refer to it periodically to make sure that you're keeping your new acquisitions. Actually, it is what I've always done. Every time I found unfamiliar word, I always write it on my notebook, then I will find the meaning of that words, and then I also look for the synonyms. It is also in line with the suggestion from Rob Rennick and Martin Sketchley to have look for the synonyms. So after we find the meaning, then we have to look for the synonym. In order to expand your vocabulary knowledge, it will give you a greater bank of vocabulary that you can use in every situations. And the last is practice saying a lot. Yes, it's very important. After you know it, then you have to practice it in your daily conversations. And I think it's going to be the last part of our presentation, which is the conclusion. Next slide, please. All right, so I will conclude. Expanding vocabulary knowledge may be accomplished in a variety of ways, one of which is through the use of Webtoon. This method has been shown to be effective in expanding vocabulary, as we can see from the survey that I conducted and also from the research conducted before. It is shown to be effective using Webtoon in for college students. And it is because a Webtoon has a benefits over simply reading a text, because you know, we can see the visualizations, we can guess it, the meaning. So, and I can say that Webtoon is a fun way to learn vocabulary. So if you want to learn a vocabulary with a fun way, then you have to start learning, read the Webtoons. That's all for me. Thank you so much. I'll look forward for your questions, and I'll give it back to moderator. I'm Agnesia Fangogeni. Thank you.
Thank you, Agnesia, for your great explanation. All right, everyone, I would like to invite the next presenter, Nidan Fitria Ramadhani, with her topic, Teaching EFL Student Vocabulary Using Card Mixing. Nidan, please.
All right, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. First of all, I would like to say thank you to Kazafira for moderating our webinar, and also thank you to the lecturer of Academic Listening and Speaking course, Ms. Arini Nurul Hidayati, for guiding me to become a presenter. And hello, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for joining our webinar. It's really great to see you all here. And my name is Nidaan Fitria Ramadhani. So today I would like to bring a topic that related to vocabulary teaching strategy. So for the topic is about teaching EFL students vocabulary using card mixing. Next, please. All right, and in my presentation, I would divide it into four sections. The first is introduction of card mixing. The second is how to teach vocabulary using card mixing. The third is it card mixing useful to teach vocabulary? And the last is conclusion. And all right, before I start to deliver my presentation, next please, moderator. I'd like to ask to all the audience here, have you ever learned vocabulary using card mixing by your teacher in your school? Please give me some reaction, or you can answer it on the chat box. All right, I feel like all of you might be unfamiliar with card mixing, but it is okay, because today we are going to talk about card mixing for teaching vocabulary. Next, please. So, without any further ado, let's start by talking about card mixing. According to Ramadhan Yarti in 2018, that code mixing is mixing of different varieties of language. For example, we use two languages in learning or teaching process. For example, in English course, in English classroom, and you know, Indonesia is a student, is EFL student, so they use between English and Indonesia, where English are as their second language and Indonesia as their first language. So while in English classroom or English course, they might use English and Indonesia. And the mix of two languages here in the strategy hopes to make the students more understand with the vocabulary that they learn or that they get in the classroom. And according to Chalik in 2003, that code mixing is used as a means of presentation when it is hard for learners to understand the meaning of words in the target language. And so the teacher can to use native tongue to facilitate things to the students or reformulate the keywords of the objectives that are settled at the beginning. And yeah, using a code mixing is using code mixing, it can be useful when the learners didn't understand with the words in the target language. So code mixing is not only used for knowing the new vocabulary, but also the students can know the meaning of each vocabulary. And many teachers in Indonesia sometimes do code mixing using their mother tongue, Indonesia, in their classroom, because to make the students more understand with the explanation and also can engage some new vocabulary. And next, please. So how to teach vocabulary using code mixing? And there's an activity from Sabri in 2018. For example, in every week, students have to memorize 5 English words in their environment. For example, the first week, the students have to memorize 5 place names, and the second week, 5 animal names, and next week, 5 famous place names. And from that activity, in each week, the students can use those words in learning process. Then the students ask to communicate by the teacher with the teacher or friend using those words. But if the students cannot understand, the teacher can mix it with Indonesian words. So the explanation is more understand. Also, they can know what is the meaning of the words that they use in the conversation. Next, please. So is it code mixing useful to teach vocabulary? Yes, it is really useful because the result of the activity that I delivered before, that the students get more interest in code mixing as new strategy to teach in learning vocabulary. And because they said they more understand in learning vocabulary. And according to Chalik in 2003, that introducing new vocabulary using code mixing yielded effective and efficient results. And we know, we have already know that vocabulary is really important in our life, and vocabulary is the basic of our language. So without vocabulary, we cannot do communication, and we cannot understand everything we see, we listen, and we read, especially in learning process. Vocabulary used for teachers and students to get some knowledge. Therefore, the teacher can use code mixing to teach vocabulary to their students because it's really useful. And also, according to Mugiono in 2017, and cited in Sabri in 2019, that the code mixing helps the students to improve their vocabulary in English and familiarize students when communicating with friends or the teachers. Next, please. So it can be concluded from my presentation is code mixing can use as effective strategy to teach vocabulary by Indonesian teacher to EFL students. And based on the research, the students feel more understand in learning vocabulary using code mixing. And also, this strategy is not only improving the vocabulary, but also knowing the meaning of each vocabulary. And here there is one quote from Bai in 2018. He said, every kind of vocabulary learning method is very useful and valuable. So it means there is no regulation about the use of code mixing as necessary or prohibited, because it depends on you as the teacher use code mixing while teaching vocabulary to your students. Next, please. So here my references of my presentation. And thank you for your attention. I will give it back to Kazafira. Thank you.
Thank you, Fornidan, for your great explanation. All right, everyone, I would like to invite the last presenter, Dwilingga Putra Kurnia, with his topic, Smartphone, a Digital Tool for Reading Comprehension. Dwilingga, please.
Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, moderator, for hosting the meeting, and thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak. Introduce myself. My name is Dwilingga Putra Kurnia from Class D of English Education. On this occasion, I will bring the topic of smartphones, a digital tool for reading comprehension. And I divide this presentation into three parts, mainly is introduction, content, and conclusion. All right, I will immediately present the topic that I will continue. Next slide, please. Okay, the first point I will continue is, what is reading comprehension? Reading comprehension is the ability to process text, understand the meaning of the text and not what the reader knows. Individuals' ability to understand text is influenced by their skill and their ability to process information. Wallis states that reading comprehension is the process of making meaning from text. Therefore, the aim is to gain an overall understanding of what is described in the text rather than to derive meaning from isolated words or sentences. According to Klingner, reading comprehension involves more than just the reader's response to the text. Reading comprehension is very complex, multi-component process involving many interactions between readers and what they bring to the text, as well as variables related to the text itself. Next slide, please. Okay, the next point is advantages of digital tools in learning process. With the existence of digital tools, especially smartphones, it clearly has many advantages. Mainly, information is more quickly obtained and access for educational purposes. The emergence of e-learning innovations that make learning develop and facilitate the educational process. And subject matter can be made more interesting and interactive. According to Huang et al., mobile learning applications can facilitate students not only learning content comfortably, but also interacting with others collaboratively anytime and anywhere. Next slide, please. Okay, how to use smartphone in the classroom. According to Bachelor, the procedure for using smartphone in the classroom is as follows. The first is students have to figure out which apps to download. The second is check how useful the app is. Third, students must then install the app. Fourth, try the appropriate application whether it can be used or not. In conducting this research, we follow several steps to implement smartphone in the classroom. The steps are modifications of the steps or procedures with Bachelor. The first is check students' smartphone and their Android version. The second is inform the application that will be used in learning. Third, ask students to download or install the app on Play Store. Fourth, make sure the applications can be used or not. Fifth, give assignments to students. And the last is explain students' assignments. To facilitate students' understanding in the classroom, teacher competence in teaching is needed. Teacher must build students' competencies, including competence to answer questions given by the teacher. The teacher can use the available media with students to understand the meaning of the text and can answer questions related to the text. In today's modern era, technology media such as smartphones can be used in teaching English, especially in reading activities. Next slide, please. Next point is the benefits of students in using smartphones to improve reading comprehension. In book software digital or ebook, the teacher can provide certain notes on the material, looking for certain words or sentences in the material. Displaying the file multimedia can be rotated to enrich book content. It is very help students understand better teaching materials, interesting and faster. Smartphones are used by female and female students for digital reading, such as reading e-books, e-news, online reading texts, or online comics. According to Buck, McKinney, Sandoff, 21st century students are not limited to knowledge about life, even in classroom environment where there are now various forms of technology. Okay, next. All right, now to the last part, which is the conclusion of this topic. Reading comprehension is process of making meaning out of text. The goal is to gain and solve understanding. Mobile learning applications can facilitate students not only to learn content comfortably, but also to interact with other people collaboratively anytime and anywhere. This is a reference to the topic that I conveyed. That's all from me. Thank you for your attention. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'll give it back to moderator.
Thank you, Duolingo, for your great explanation. All right, everyone, so that is the end of the presentation session. Now we move to the next session. This is Q&A session. We have 3 until 5 minutes to answer the question. So if you have any question, you can put in the chat box, or if you want to the presenters, you can just raise your hand or on your mic. Yes, Tikri Hakim, you can on your mic or put in the chat box. All right, yes, please.
I would like to give a question for Ms. Putri. And here's the question. If in the future you become a teacher, will you combine online games, especially Kahoot, with language learning? And is that a good solution?
All right, so the question from Dikri is asked to the presenter, Putri Permatasari. You want to answer directly or we move to the next question?
I think I will answer directly.
All right.
Okay, thank you, Dikri. It's a good question. Because technology is very familiar and has become a part of our lives, especially in the next 5 years or 10 years from now. Therefore, if I become a teacher, I will combine online game, especially Kahoot, in language learning because it is very useful, especially for students who have learning difficulties and will help students improve their language learning skills. And I think it is a very good solution if online games are combined in language learning. Thank you. I hope this answer can help you. Thank you.
All right, Degree, is that enough?
Enough, miss.
All right, for the next question, maybe from the Mrs. Melissa. You can turn your mic, please.
Right, thank you very much. It's a very good opportunity for me to congratulate you all. You've made some kind of good performance. So happy to see that. And my question is actually for Agnia. Hello there, are you there?
Yes, ma'am, I'm here.
Okay, so I am actually interested in as what you have already done by the what is it called, the survey, the results of the survey. Most of the participants seems like answering it very positively towards the vocabulary, but then there must be some kind of negative potential or somehow as I discussed with one of the lecturers that the pictures, or somehow webtoons is threatening when it is related to kind of certain pictures, right? So how do you make sure that, what kind of suggestions you would like to give to any persons that would like to improve the vocabulary by seeing this threatening potential? Thank you.
Thank you for Ms. Melissa. Maybe Agnia, you can directly answer the question.
I don't think that is here with us now, but I'm not sure. Possibly you can move to other questioners.
All right.
Thank you.
For our next question, we have Siska Auliani, please. I guess Siska Auliani have a problem. Maybe we can find in the chat box from Datami that she would like to ask to Dwilinga that you said earlier that reading ebooks using a smartphone can improve reading comprehension. The question is, what are the advantages of ebooks compared to printed books? Maybe Dwilinga, you can directly answer the question.
Yes. All right. Thank you for the question from Letami, and I will answer the question. What are the advantages of ebooks compared to printed books? In my opinion, the advantage of ebooks is that they are more practical, because they are supported by digital technology. So all book collections are stored in one application or file. That way we can easily find the books we want to read anywhere and anytime. And another advantage, in my opinion, the possibility of damage to ebooks will be minimal due to the nature of ebooks that do not have a physical form in the form of paper or sheets. That's all from me. Thank you.
All right, Datami, is that enough?
Yes, that's enough. Thank you.
All right. I would like to apologize to everyone that the time is end. And for Ms. Melissa, maybe Agnia can directly answer from the email. Yes, thank you,
everyone. All right, no problem. Yeah.
Thank you, Miss. All right, everyone, so we can summarize from today's webinar that English is significant, that learning English as a language development can use in various ways, but what's using those like songs, role plays, flashcards, and etc. So that's why we can conclude that this has been taught by the presenters. Before we end this meeting, I would like to move to the photo session. So for everyone, you can turn on your camera. Okay, for the first slide. One, two, three. And then second slide. Okay, we just have second slide, I guess, because there is some of them who didn't open the camera. Okay. One, two, three. Thank you everyone for your participation. And finally, we come to the last session of this webinar series. Thank you for the presenters who are delivering your presentation. And also thank you very much to all audiences for your participation. Hopefully the discussion that we have shared today will be useful for all of us. Amin. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you so much, everyone.